नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ऑर्गेनिज्म बियर होलो एंड न्यूमैटिक बॉर्न। देखिए हमें इन्होंने हिंट क्या दे दिया, होलो एंड न्यूमैटिक। होलो एंड न्यूमैटिक बोन किसका करेक्टरिस्टिक है, स्पेशल करेक्टर है, किसमें? एव्स का, बर्ड्स का। यानी कि बर्ड्स में न्यूमैटिक बोन होंगी तभी तो इजीली फ्लाई करना करेंगी। तो हमें इनमें क्या देखना है कि इनमें से जो है कौन सा ऑप्शन है जो बर्ड्स को रिप्रेजेंट करता है। सबसे पहले बात करें हेमीडेक्टाइलस, क्या है ये? लिजार्ड है। कहां जाएगा? रेप्टाइल्स में नहीं हो सकता। मैक्रोपस मैमल नहीं हो सकता। ऑर्निथ्रिक्स प्लैटिपस नहीं हो सकता। तो अपने आप जब तीन गलत हो गए तो अपने आप करेक्ट आंसर कौन सा जाएगा? तीन रॉन्ग है एक राइट है, यानी कि करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज न्यूफ्रॉन, वल्चर है बेटा ये, ओके बर्ड है, ओके। तो आंसर क्या जाएगा? न्यूफ्रॉन, ओके। तो इसका करेक्ट आंसर जो जाएगा वो जाएगा फोर्थ। डन 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 प्यारे बच्चों, चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पर चलते हैं। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रिसेप्टर फॉर स्पर्म बाइंडिंग। तो स्पर्म बाइंडिंग, रिसेप्टर फॉर स्पर्म बाइंडिंग, स्पर्म के बाइंड होने के लिए जो रिसेप्टर्स हैं वो कहां पाए जाते हैं? तो रिसेप्टर किसके लिए पूछ रहा है? स्पर्म बाइंडिंग इन मैमल्स आर प्रेजेंट ऑन, ओके। यानी कि हम पढ़ते हैं कि कौन सी ऐसी मेम्ब्रेन है जिस पर ये पाए जाते हैं। पहले क्या दिया हुआ है? विटेलाइन मेम्ब्रेन। प्रीविटेलाइन स्पेस मैमल्स में कहां है बेटा? तो ये क्या हो गया? फर्स्ट ऑप्शन गलत। प्रीविटेलाइन ये भी क्या हो गया? गलत। अब सबसे ज्यादा कंफ्यूजन कहां होगा? जोना पेलुसिडा और कोरोना रेडिएटा में। याद रखना कोरोना रेडिएटा तो पेनिट्रेट होकर अंदर आया, उसके बाद आपने तीन लेयर पढ़ी होगी, ZP1, ZP2, ZP3। तो यानी कि ZP जो है, जोना पेलुसिडा जो है, उसी पर क्या पाए जाते हैं? आपके रिसेप्टर्स पाए जाते हैं। तो इसका जो करेक्ट आंसर जाएगा वो क्या जाएगा? थर्ड, जोना पेलुसिडा। डन 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 प्यारे बच्चों, चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पर चलते हैं।
Now student, let us come to the next question. Here the question is, a specific recognition sequences identified by endonuclease to make cuts at a specific position within the DNA is. Here the options are, option number 1, Okazaki sequences, option number 2, palindromic nucleotide sequences, option number 3, poly A tail sequences, and option number 4, degenerate primer sequence. So student, which option here is the correct one? We know that student, if you are talking about a specific recognition sequences, a specific recognition sequence identified by the endonuclease enzyme. Identified by the endonuclease. Identified by endonuclease to cut at a specific position. Specific position. Within DNA molecule it is called palindromic nucleotide sequence. It is called palindromic nucleotide sequences. We know that student, a specific recognition sequence identified by endonuclease to cut at a specific position of the DNA, it is called palindromic nucleotide sequence. So student, here correct answer, it is option number 2, palindromic nucleotide sequence. Correct answer, option number 2. Now student, let us come to the next question. Here the question is, in a cross between a male and a female, बोथ हेटरोजाइगस फॉसिकल सेल एनीमिया जीन व्हाट परसेंटेज ऑफ द प्रोजेनी विल बी डिजीज. हियर द ऑप्शंस आर ऑप्शन नंबर 1 75%, ऑप्शन नंबर 2 25%, ऑप्शन नंबर 3 100% एंड ऑप्शन नंबर 4 50%. सो स्टूडेंट हियर व्हिच ऑप्शन इज द करेक्ट वन. नाउ स्टूडेंट हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट मेल एंड फीमेल, बोथ आर हेटरोजाइगस फॉर सिकल सेल एनीमिया. सो व्हाट आर देयर जीन्स? वी नो दैट स्टूडेंट इट इज HbA एंड HbS. इट विल रिप्रेजेंट the heterozygous for sickle cell anemia, and we know that both male and female are heterozygous for sickle cell anemia. That means it is HbA and HbS. So we can write here, student, HbA and other parent HbS. That is one parent, and another parent, it is of the same type. It is HbA and it is HbS. Now let us make a cross in between them. So what will we get? Now here we have to done the cross in between the two parents which are heterozygous for the sickle cell anemia, HbA, HbA. Here we find the genotype HbA and HbA. Here HbA and HbS. So here we find the genotype HbA and HbS. Here HbA and HbS, HbA and HbS. Here HbS and HbS, HbS and here HbS. So out of the four progeny, if we find the ratio HbA, HbA, it is the normal. This offspring is normal, HbA, HbS. This offspring is carrier. Carrier. This offspring is also being a carrier, and this offspring is diseased for the sickle cell anemia. So how many percentage of this progeny will get a disease of this sickle cell anemia? Normal. Only one. Normal, only one. And the gene for that, it is HbA and HbA. Carrier for the sickle cell anemia disease, it is 2. So the genes for that, it is HbA and HbS. And the disease for the sickle cell anemia, student, disease, how many offspring get disease? It is only one. And the genes for that, it is HbS and HbS. So out of the four, only one get disease. So the ratio of the progeny which will get disease, it is only 25%. Out of the four, only one is disease, which is HbS. So the correct answer for this question, it is 25%. Here correct answer option number 2. Now student, let us come to the next question. Here the question is, which is the only enzyme that has capability to catalyze initiation, elongation and termination in the process of transcription in prokaryotes? Here the options are option number 1, DNA dependent RNA polymerase, option number 2, DNA ligase, option number 3, DNAs, and option number 4, DNA dependent DNA polymerase. So student, which option here is the correct one? We know that student, it is option number 1, DNA dependent RNA polymerase. We know that student, DNA dependent RNA polymerase is the only enzyme that has capability to catalyze initiation, elongation and termination in the process of transcription in prokaryotes. So student, we know that what will happen in prokaryotes. In prokaryotes, it is DNA dependent. RNA polymerase is the only enzyme that has capability to catalyze initiation, elongation and termination in the process of the transcription. So student, here correct answer, it is option number one, DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Option number one, correct answer.
Next question is succus entricus. Digestion and absorption से ये question है. Is referred to as succus entricus. बताइए सबसे पहले saliva, फिर bile juice, फिर हमने कहा pancreatic juice और फिर intestinal juice. और इस intestinal juice को ही क्या कहते हैं? Succus entricus. कब कहते हैं? जब इसमें non-enzymatic and enzymatic part mix होते हैं तो उसे क्या कहा जाता है? Succus entricus. तो किसको refer कर रहा है बेटा? Intestinal juice को. Gastric juice नहीं होता, काइम नहीं होता, pancreatic juice नहीं होता. तो correct answer जो जाएगा इसका क्या जाएगा? Intestinal juice. डन 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 प्यारे बच्चों. तो question और answer दोनों बहुत simple तरीके से, easy तरीके से आपके सामने है. हमने कहा succus entricus, intestinal juice. कंफर्म. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पर चलते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है आपका रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ से. देखिए क्या कह रहा है. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ हार्मोन रिलीजिंग इंट्रा यूटेराइन डिवाइस. इंट्रा यूटेराइन डिवाइस है कौन सी? हार्मोन रिलीजिंग. इनमें से हमें क्या करना है? सेलेक्ट करना है. सबसे पहले हम बात कर रहे हैं किसकी? LNG20 की. LNG20 क्या कॉपर रिलीजिंग होती है? नहीं होती. यही एक डिवाइस है जो यहां पर क्या होती है? हार्मोन रिलीजिंग होती है. हम फर्स्ट ऑप्शन ही राइट है, लेकिन फिर भी अपन अपने सुकून के लिए नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन देख लेते हैं. कॉपर 7 नहीं है, मल्टीलोड नहीं है, कॉपर टी नहीं है. तो इसका जो करेक्ट आंसर जाएगा वो क्या जाएगा? LNG20 डायरेक्ट दिया हुआ है बेटा. NCERT की लाइन टू लाइन से क्वेश्चन है कि जो LNG20 है वो क्या है? आपकी हार्मोन रिलीजिंग IUD. डन बच्चों. चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पर चलते हैं. बहुत इजी क्वेश्चन है, बहुत इजीली हो गया होगा. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वेनेरल डिजीज कैन स्प्रेड थ्रू. ए ऑप्शन इज यूजिंग स्टेराइल नीडल्स, बी ऑप्शन इज ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन, सी इन्फेक्टेड मदर टू फीटस, डी किसिंग और ई इनहेरिटेंस. चूज द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द ऑप्शन गिवन बिलो. ओके, क्वेश्चन इज ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिजीज, नो रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. ओके, यूजिंग स्टेराइड नीडल्स. ओके, यू चूज करेक्ट आंसर. यूजिंग स्टेराइल नीडल्स बच्चों, यस या नो? यूजिंग स्टेराइल नीडल्स वेनल डिजीज कैन स्प्रिंट थ्रू. चूज द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द ऑप्शन गिवन बिलो. स्टेराइल नीडल्स वायरल डिजीज स्प्रेड. स्टेराइल नीडल स्टेराइल दिया हुआ है, गिवन स्टेराइल. सो दिस ऑप्शन इज नॉट करेक्ट. ओके, ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन, यस. ओके, ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन इज राइट. इन्फेक्टेड मदर टू फिटस, यस. किसिंग, नो. If both kissing, tongue to tongue, is possible, but only kissing not possible. Inheritance, transfer, progeny, यानी कि parents to offspring, it is wrong. तो correct answer is B and C only. Correct answer is B and C only.
Now student, let us come to the next question. Here the question is, Dobson units are used to measure thickness of. Here the options are option number one, stratosphere, option number two, ozone, option number three, troposphere, and option number four, CFC. So student, which option here is the correct one? We know that student, the thickness of the ozone, the thickness of the ozone layer, the thickness of the ozone layer is measured in Dobson unit. So student, here the Dobson unit is the measurement for the thickness of the ozone layer. Here correct answer, it is option number two.
Next question, पर चलते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज पर्सन विद एबी ब्लड ग्रुप. किसकी बात कर रहे हैं? एबी ब्लड ग्रुप की. एबी ब्लड ग्रुप को क्या बोलते हैं? यूनिवर्सल एक्सेप्टर. बिल्कुल बोलते हैं सर, है ना. हमने कहा यूनिवर्सल जो एक्सेप्टर है हम उसे क्या कहते हैं बेटा? भिखारी. और मैंने आपको बताया था कि भिखारी का कोई दुश्मन नहीं होता, यानी कि भिखारी में एंटीबॉडी नहीं होती. क्लियर बात? यहीं से क्वेश्चन आ गया. देखिए मैंने कहा भी था आएगा क्वेश्चन यहां से. हमने कहा एब्सेंस ऑफ एंटीजन. एंटीजन तो होते हैं ना बेटा, क्योंकि एंटीजन मतलब एंटीजन यानी कि वैसे, यानी कि भिखारी जैसे भिखारी बहुत होते हैं, तो एब्सेंस दिया हुआ है यानी कि ये नहीं होगा. प्रेजेंस ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. हमने कहा प्रेजेंस ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. क्या भिखारी का कोई दुश्मन हो सकता है? नहीं हो सकता. तो ये भी क्या हो गया? रॉन्ग हो गया. यानी प्रेजेंस ऑफ एंटीबॉडी नहीं होती. हमने क्या क्या पूछ रहा है वो? यूनिवर्सल रिसिपिएंट. यानी कि हमने कहा क्या नहीं होती एंटीजन में? हम यूनिवर्सल एक्सेप्टर में, एबी में, हमने कहा एबी का कोई दुश्मन नहीं होता. भिखारी का कोई दुश्मन देखा है क्या आपने? नहीं होता. यानी कि एंटीबॉडी नहीं होगी. तो हमने कहा कि एब्सेंस ऑफ एंटीबॉडी बिल्कुल करेक्ट आंसर है बच्चों. क्यों? हमने कहा एंटी ए एंड एंटी बी इन प्लाज्मा. तो इसका जो करेक्ट आंसर जाएगा वो क्या जाएगा? आपका थर्ड. ओके, तो एक्सप्लेनेशन आपको समझ में आया होगा. बहुत सिंपल है. चलते हैं नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पर.
नाउ स्टूडेंट लेट अस कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. हियर द क्वेश्चन इज व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आरएनएज इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ प्रोटीन. हियर द ऑप्शंस आर ऑप्शन नंबर 1 टीआरएनए, ऑप्शन नंबर 2 आरआरएनए, ऑप्शन नंबर 3 एसआईआरएनए एंड ऑप्शन नंबर 4 mRNA. So student here, which option is correct one? We know that student, if you are talking about the process of the synthesis of protein. So which of the following RNAs are used in the synthesis of the protein? We know that student, for the synthesis of the protein, the RNA required, it is tRNA. tRNA is transfer RNA. Another RNA which is required for the synthesis of protein, it is mRNA. mRNA is messenger RNA. And another RNA which is used for the synthesis of protein, it is rRNA. rRNA is ribosomal RNA. So which RNA is not required for the synthesis of the protein, student? It is siRNA. So student, here the correct answer, it is option number 3.
Hello students, welcome to the class. Let's have a look toward the question of NEET 2021. Ready? So the first question is, which of the following statement wrongly represent the nature of smooth muscle? Clear? Look at the question. The question says wrongly represent means the question is asking about what? It is asking about the incorrect statement, right? Which one is incorrect regarding what? Regarding your smooth muscle. Clear? Do you know which type of muscle is a smooth muscle? The smooth muscle is also known as what? It is also known as involuntary muscle. Why it is named as involuntary muscle? Because it is not in control of our CNS. Clear? Our brain, our body cannot control. That's why it is named as involuntary muscle. So the question are, they are involuntary muscle, correct? So this statement is correct. The second, communication among the cell is performed by intercalated disc. Does there is a intercalated disc is found in a smooth muscle? No. Whenever we are talking about the smooth muscle is named as what? It is also named as non-striated muscle, because it don't have any bands, any striations in between them. So that's why it is named as non-striated muscle. So this intercalated disc is found in which muscle? It is found in the cardiac muscle. So it is not present in this smooth muscle. Clear? So this statement is incorrect, right? The next statement, these muscles are present in the wall of blood vessel, right? The smooth muscle is found in all the blood vessels, is lined by this smooth muscle. This muscle have no striation, as I have written. This is also known as non-striated muscle. So for this question, the question is asking which is the wrongly or the incorrect match. So the incorrect one for the smooth muscle is The second option, the communication among the cell is performed by intercalated disc, is totally incorrect. So the answer goes to what? Answer goes to second. Clear? Copy down. Hello students, let's have a look toward the next question. The question is what? Which of the following is the characteristic is incorrect with respect to cockroach? Great question of the lower animals from the animal tissue. The question is of NEET 2021. When we are talking about the animal tissue, in the animal tissue, whenever we are talking about the cockroach, so in the cockroach, what it is saying that incorrect. The hypopharynx lies within the cavity and close by the mouth part. It is correct about it. When we are talking about the buccal cavity having the following part like hypopharynx, like labrum and different. So this statement is correct. In females, 7 to 9 cisterna together form a genital pouch. It is correct that 7 segment, 8 segment and 9 segment forms what? It forms the genital pouch. It is the correct statement. The next one is what? In the 10th abdominal segment, both sexes have anal sulci. It is also the correct statement. The fourth, a ring of gastric cecum is present at the junction of midgut and hindgut. It is completely incorrect statement because the ring of gastric cecum is not found at the midgut and hindgut. So the correct answer for your question goes to what? It goes to the fourth one. Clear? Copy that question. Okay, students, let's have a look toward the next question. The next question is, which one of the following belongs to the family Musidae? Whoa, it's a great question of the NEET 2021, because we always says you in the class when you are studying, always read the classes of Arthropoda, right? The Arthropoda and the Chordata, two phylum having the important classes. That's why we are saying you to just learn the classes of this phylum also. So the question is from the class of Arthropoda, the question of NEET 2021. So question is from the phylum Arthropoda, right? The phylum is which one? The phylum is Arthropoda, right? And it is what? It is the largest phylum. As you know what? The Arthropoda is what? The Arthropoda is largest phylum, correct? And the class when we are talking about, the class we are talking about, Musidae. The Musidae is having what? These classes is having the flies, right? This classes is having the flies. So when we are talking about which of the following belong to the family Musidae, so we are saying that the fly, and which type of fly? So it is a house fly, not a grasshopper, not a cockroach, not a firefly. So the correct answer for your question goes to what? The correct answer for your question goes to the third, that's one house fly. Clear? Thank you. Okay, students, let's have a look toward the next question. The next question is what? Erythropoietin hormone, which stimulates the RBC formation, is produced by, a very interesting question from the excretion and the elimination chapter. The question is of NEET 2021. The question is asking about which hormone? It is asking about the erythropoietin hormone, right? It is asking about what? It is asking about the erythropoietin hormone. Do you know? It is talking about what? Erythropoietin hormone, which stimulates the RBC production. Just remember, whenever our kidney failure is there, whenever our kidney stop functioning, what is the first thing to be affected? Whenever our kidney is not functioning properly, the first thing is affected the blood formation. In our body, there is a decrement in the RBC. The RBC cannot be formed. The reason behind what? Our kidney is what? The kidney secretes what? This kidney secretes an hormone, that's why named as erythropoietin hormone. Clear? It secretes an hormone that is named as erythropoietin hormone. It stimulates what? It stimulates the bone marrow. Clear? Erythropoietin hormone stimulates what? It stimulates the bone marrow. Clear? It stimulates bone marrow. For what it stimulates the bone marrow? The bone marrow then start producing what? It start producing the RBC. So all clear? When we are talking about the erythropoietin hormone, it is secreted by kidney, and kidney having a cell that is named as what? That cell is named as JG cell. This JG cell responsible for the formation of erythropoietin hormone. After the erythropoietin hormone, it just go to the bone marrow. The red bone marrow get stimulated and start producing the RBC. So question is very good. The erythropoietin hormone which stimulate the RBC is produced by the cells of rostral adenophysis. No, it is the incorrect statement. The cells of bone marrow, no. The cells of bone marrow produces the RBC, not the hormones. Clear? The second, the juxtaglomerular cell of the kidney is the correct answer, not the alpha cell of pancreas, because we know the alpha cell of pancreas secretes the glucagon. So the answer for this question goes to what? It goes to the third one. Clear? Copy down.